recently we did the postpartum depression survey, qualitative study, and we've got part two of that that's been submitted. Found some interesting results there. And then we also looked at school-wide positive behavioral support, and it was the first study that I know of. It was a longitudinal study, four-year study at an elementary school. And right now, working with some folks on the beginning of doing what we, it's called treatment fit, and it's more of the trans-theoretical model of counseling. Meaning, and what I mean by that is when you're looking at what are the overriding things that make a difference in counseling, regardless of theory, whether it's cognitive behavior or whatever, and one of the things is treatment fit, the degree to which the counselor and client agree as to the issues, the goals, and the treatment plan. What's interesting, I think, is we're going to tie that in. It's a best practices article at this point. We're going to tie it in with a video. So once folks read the article, there'll be a video link that they can go and see it being done. And which I think, to me, is cool because I love when reading a best practice article to be able to, okay, I've read it. I think I've got a good idea how to do it. Now I'd like to see somebody doing it. Well, I think with the positive behavioral support is certainly picking up speed. So I'm going back to the school, and just the positive behavioral support is essentially changing the environment within school where folks, everybody, faculty, administration, and even students are looking for what people are doing well and recognizing that. And the fact that we do have this first longitudinal study in elementary school, I think it got noticed. The person who created positive behavioral support actually sent us an email once it was published. So I think folks are noticing that, and they're seeing that this can make a difference and improve school environment. The postpartum depression is fascinating because what we do find is that the instruments out there to measure this in folks are, they don't include things such as the degree of homicidality, if that's a word, that the parent may have. Also the degree to which the troubling thoughts are getting in the way of functioning. And so a next step with that would be to actually create an instrument that captures everything that these folks experience. And then there's a whole other realm with that, which is I'm very interested in integrated care of behavioral health professionals working with medical professionals. Physicians do not do a great job of asking parents about what they're experiencing because A, they don't have much time, and B, if someone were to say, oh yeah, I am having some unusual thoughts or thoughts of harming my child, then that could be the rest of their day trying to figure out, does this person need to be committed or so forth. So that's the whole idea with the integrated care. We just finished a textbook on that, which is due out in March, and had a bunch of people collaborating within Western on that one, from the School of Nursing to Human Resource to counseling. With treatment fit, that just seems to be what folks are finally starting to realize is that the theory itself doesn't matter as much as if we're doing some of the, we're creating a culture of feedback, like every other institution in the world has to do, and that counseling has not done that, or mental health hasn't done that. So that's what the treatment fit is about, is creating that culture of feedback and making sure that we're on the same page with clients. I wake up every day excited about it. I guess I'm a little scattered in which directions I want to go, but the fact that you can impact, you can make an impact, and you see that this can actually help, and ultimately what I want is what works for folks in counseling. So whatever I'm doing, that's kind of what I'm looking at, is what works. So being able to get that out there, and through whatever venue that might be, whether journal articles or you know, through social media or what have you, and hopefully folks can make progress in improving the care delivery of counseling and healthcare. The colleagues are great. When I came out here, I just fell in love. I think the fact that it's such a beautiful place, and we're surrounded. The beautiful mountains and trees and so forth, that it just, it's inspiring, and I think it also attracts folks who are bright and altruistic and kind and motivated, and I've just enjoyed getting to know everybody and work with folks, and there's just always a slew of folks to collaborate with.